Welcome back to Harbaugh. When Obama, President Obama, gave a speech Monday at a Phoenix arena about a dozen people carrying guns, including one man with a military-style semi-automatic rifle, were among the protesters outside. Just last week, when the president spoke in Portsmouth, New Hampshire, a man outside the event had a gun strapped to his leg, and in a separate incident in Portsmouth, a man was arrested for having a loaded, unlicensed gun in his car near the school where Obama, the president, held the health care forum. Ronald Reagan's host of the Ron Reagan Show on Air America Radio and Alan Gottlieb founded the Second Amendment Foundation. Mr. Gottlieb, why would a person bring a gun to a presidential event?
Well, I think the only legitimate reason to bring a gun would be for self-defense, and in which case it would be a lot better to carry it concealed with a license to do so than open carry the way they were doing it. I think, quite honestly, politically, it's not a very astute decision to make. While it's maybe legal, I think it doesn't help the pro-gun rights cause when you see people do that.
What do you think is their motivation?
I really think, Chris, that their motivation was is they know that President Obama is very anti-gun rights, and they're basically in-your-face kind of thing, saying, it's my right and I can do it. But I don't think it really sells well, and I don't think it gets much converts to our cause.
You really believe that?
Yeah.
You're not just BSing me here right now. You really believe this is about gun rights and his position on gun rights, even though we've had Democratic presidents for years who take basically the same position he's taken on gun rights. And nobody's shown up at events carrying guns, ever.
Well, I don't think they've been quite as firm. There's no doubt that Obama's the most anti-gun rights president we've had in the history of the United States, based on his past performance, his actions, his voting record, and statements that he's made.
And okay, I'm going to go. I don't agree with you, okay, but you're right. I think there's a more deep-seated reason here. I think it has to do with people's sort of real ideologies involved here. Let me go to Ron Reagan. Ron, it seems to me the problem we've had with presidents is that people who've come to events with guns have used them. I'm just going through a history here. Your dad, of course, suffered from that. 1865, Lincoln. 1880, we elected Garfield. He was killed. 1900, McKinley. Teddy Roosevelt was shot at. I think it was speech in his pocket saved his life. FDR was shot at. The mayor of Chicago was killed by that assassin attempts. Harry Truman was attacked by Puerto Rican nationalists. A Secret Service agent was killed defending him at the Blair House. Gerald Ford was shot at twice. Jack Kennedy was killed when he was shot. And your dad was almost killed. Your thoughts on this subject. Why do people bring guns to presidential events?
Well, I think it's a much bigger thing than Alan is suggesting. I don't think it's about Second Amendment rights. I don't think it's about health care or any of the specific issues here. The future is coming, Chris, and many people are scared of the future. This is one of those pivotal moments in our history when you can sense that something is happening, something is going to change, and many people get very frightened by that. Some people can hire lobbyists to push back against that change. Other people who don't have that capacity do things like carry guns around. Alan is quite right. The only real reason to carry a loaded handgun or assault-style rifle anywhere, hunting, target practice, or you intend to kill someone in self-defense. Now, they're not going hunting. They're not going for target practice. So who is it that they think they might have to kill? Well, they're holding up signs that say, talking about the Tree of Liberty needing to be watered with the blood of tyrants and patriots. Maybe that gives us a little hint there.
What are the rules of engagement, Mr. Gottlieb, for the people who bring guns? In other words, under what circumstances would they use them in one of these crowded events?
Well, first of all, take a look, Chris, what's legal and not, and it changes all across the country.
No, under what circumstances would they use the guns?
Oh, well,
in a public event like this with people crowding around a president at a school somewhere, under what circumstances at such an event, which is where they're bringing the gun, would they use it?
Well, this is an outside rally area with people protesting on all sides of an issue, and sometimes they get violent. For self-protection, you may want to protect yourself against somebody that wants to do some violence to you.
I wish I had you under sodium pentothal, sir. Do you honestly believe that somebody brings these guns because they think somebody else in the crowd is going to kill them?
Chris, I'm saying that's the legitimate reason to do so.
No, but
I'm
is
not
that
saying,
the motive
wait,
here?
Chris, wait. No, I don't think that was the motive here, and I said that up front. I think that people were making a political statement. I don't think it was the right place or time to do so.
If they're making a political statement, the guns don't have to be loaded, Alan. They could simply be empty on the strung on their back. But these are loaded handguns and assault-style rifles. Well, There's no reason for that unless you're intending to use them.
Well, I can't say that I disagree with you. I don't think it was an appropriate place to have those particular firearms. But let's be honest about it. All the people were there legally, lawfully. They did not threaten anybody. They were exercising a right that's legal in the state of Arizona.
You can have a legal right that doesn't make it right. A legal right make it right.
It may not make it smart, but it was definitely right. It was legal, and that's why the police officers did not arrest anybody. They were all legal, and everybody was very well behaved, as a matter of fact. So you might want to argue an armed society could be a polite society.
Uh-huh. Until the shooting starts, yeah.
But there was no shooting, was there, at any of these events?
Well, there could be. And think about the wisdom of strapping an assault rifle, a loaded assault rifle, to your back in the midst of a crowd you can't control. It's a little silly, isn't it? Somebody could grab that gun and do God knows what with it. It's really foolishness.
I think I agree with you. I think it's foolishness.
Well,
I wouldn't do that. But at a rally like that, I might want to have my handgun, you know, that I'm licensed to carry concealed on my person, and no one would even know it's there. And it would be for my self-protection, but I wouldn't be flaunting it. And quite frankly, it'd be safer for me because the element of surprise would not be on my side.
Let me ask you, sir, if you were at the book depository in Dallas in 1963, and you happened to walk through one of the book depository rooms upstairs, and you saw a man with a rifle, what would you do?
Well, in that particular case, I would have had my handgun with me, and I don't think we'd have a dead president. I think we'd have
How would you have known that person intended to use that rifle against the president?
Well, I think it'd be kind of foolish.
Because you say you have a right to carry these guns around with you.
Chris, come on. If you see a guy pointing a rifle out a window at somebody, he's there for no good.
No, I'm saying five seconds before the pointing. I'm saying just having the gun in proximity to a presidential event.
Well, there was no reason for that person to have that gun in the book depository by standing by the window. So it's pretty obvious it was there for no good. And that's why people with firearms can help protect people.
Okay,
and they can help protect presidents as well.
Now you're really getting loony. Let me ask you this. If you're a Secret Service agent and you're watching a crowd and you're watching the people with guns that are loaded, as Ron points out, do you have to have a special agent in each case watching each guy with a gun? Because it seems like that person would require special attention. What do you think?
Well, Chris, this person wasn't
Wouldn't you, if you were a Secret Service agent?
He wasn't anywhere near where the president was. And my guess is there were no Secret Service people there. It was only local police doing crowd control because it was nowhere near where the president was. Let's be honest about it.
Well, let me ask you about this. If you were a Secret Service agent and you saw someone in the perimeter of one of the presidential events, would you keep your eye on the guy with the gun?
Of course I would. I'd be stupid not
to. How many agents are we going to have then? For every guy carrying a gun, we need an agent.
Well, no, you don't. And quite frankly, when you're having it out in public like that and everybody can see it, the odds are you're not going to do anything. It's when you can't see it that you maybe have to worry, right?
If people with loaded weapons are in the proximity, Alan, speaking as somebody who has a little more experience than you do with the Secret Service, if you've got somebody with a loaded weapon at an event that the president is at or any other politician, you're going to have security personnel watching them. They're going to be watching them
when they should be watching
something else.
Wait, again, you're right, but this wasn't an event where the president was at. He was not out in the street where these people were.
Okay, well, let me tell you, last week we have an event where now about a dozen people carrying guns showed up in Phoenix with the president. A dozen people, sir. Well, that's a lot of people for Secret Service agents to keep an eye on. So let's just kill it right now. You say they brought the guns for simple reasons, for display purposes only, right? They didn't really bring them for self-protection. They brought them for display, like burning a flag. It was a symbol. Okay.
That's what it
looked
like.
Number two, but did you see no reason otherwise to bring them? You don't really believe they brought them for self-protection then?
No, I think they were making a political statement. I don't think it was the right venue to do it.
Okay. Well, thank you.
Political statement, they don't have to be loaded. That's the bottom line there.
Well, this is about anger, Alan. We don't even know if they were loaded.
Well, they were loaded. This is about anger, and anger and guns do not mix. And that's what we're seeing at these rallies.
The fellow I had last week said, "You're stupid." He had a gun. He said it was loaded. And he challenged me. He said, "You'd be stupid. Never carry a gun unless it is loaded." He made fun of me for asking the question because he's a Second Amendment guy and he knows you have to carry a loaded gun. He told me.
Yeah, but you're making an assumption they all were loaded for all these people. And we don't know that. We know for a fact one man's guns were loaded, but we don't know they all were. You're making a statement that we don't really have any facts to back up.
Well, if they weren't loaded, Chris is right. There's no point in carrying it. Then it's just a piece of metal that's worthless.
Well, hold on. But then it's a political statement, isn't it?
Is it? Is it a political statement or is it something else, Alan?
Well, Ron, you just said it's to be a political statement. You don't have to have it loaded.
You know,
that's true, but they did have them loaded, didn't they? At least one, they did have it loaded, right?
The Second Amendment's clear, gentlemen. The Second Amendment, as interpreted by this Supreme Court, is you have an individual right to bear arms. My question is this. You have a right to jump around on a pogo stick. You don't go to church on a pogo stick. There's a right place and a right time. We agree on that, all three of us. Thank you, Ron Reagan.
Yes, Chris.
Thank you, Alan.